Hello friends, today I'll show you an app that I have created, that's Kiddish. Teacher of a nursery class wanted me to create this app. She wants me to create such an app where the animal names, the fruit names and the color names are clear to all the children. So I have created this app. Hope you like it. So, before we start with it, let me explain you the design. In the main screen, which is named as the home screen, I have a label which shows Kiddish on it. Then I have a button which shows animal on it. Then I have another button which shows fruits on it. And another button called bells. Now there's an invisible component in this app that I'll tell you later. Okay, let all of them appear. Yeah, so this is an image of a dog. This is an image component. This is an image of a cat, this is also an image component. This is an image of a hen, this is also an image component. This is an image of a crow, this is even an image component. All of these are image components. This elephant image, this parrot image, all are image components. Plus, there's a button called home. Now, in the fruit screen also, there are many images of fruits. These all are image components. See, apple, banana, mango, orange, strawberries, and watermelon. All are image components. Now, this is not an image component. This is a button. These all are buttons. There are 7 buttons in the screen. And there's a home button below. It is the 7th button. So, this designing is mainly of images. Labels, only one label is used and the button. Now I was telling you that I'll tell you what's the invisible component here. Yes, I will. So for that I need to just minimize all of them so that now in the design components there's a row component in the animal screen so that it's coming like this, one beside the other. Otherwise if I have used the column, then it would have come vertically, like one here, one here, one here. If I need to add a column, it would have been vertical, not like this. So there are 3 rows over here. Same for the fruit screen, same for the color screen. This is not a very important image component, but without this, we won't be able to place our design components properly. Here you can see, let me take a pen. Yeah. Here you can see in the invisible components place there's an option like sound one. What is the sound one? Let me clear the drawing. Here you can see in the below over here it's again written sound one. Here this is the same image, the same component. Like when I click on it, you see there are so many sounds I have added. One is strawberry mp3, watermelon mp3, like this. There are many sound components over here. Okay, so now I shift to the coding part. In the home screen, it just needs 6 lines of code. When animals button is clicked, navigate to animal screen. I think you have understood what are the labels of these buttons, and they are named accordingly in the animal screen, in the fruit screen and the color screen. Like this is an image of a chicken. It shows chicken png. So I think you won't have any problem for this. Okay, so navigate to animal screen. When fruit button is clicked, navigate to fruit screen. When color button is clicked, navigate to color screen. I think this much is clear. Navigate means shift to. Now what happens in the animal screen? When the dog is clicked, set sound one source to this dog puppy's one. I'll review this app. Don't worry. And this is placed so that the sound plays. If this is not placed over here, below this, the sound mustn't have been played. Okay. Now when the chicken is clicked, play the chicken sound. When the cat is clicked, play the cat sound. Its names are like this because these are downloaded songs, so I could not rename it. And this is the sound play button. I think you don't have any problem with this. And when the home button is clicked, navigate to home screen. When the elephant is clicked, set sound source to the elephant sound. Call sounds play with output error, then do when play is done. Okay, so this is just put to play the sound. Otherwise the sound mustn't have been played. So the same for all. So where do I get this button from? Over here you can see cat, dog, row 1, chicken, crow, row 2, elephant, parrot, row 9. For example, I take this crow option. So from here I select the when crow is clicked. I'll delete this, never mind. Set sound 1 source. So over here you can see sound 1. I click on it. Here is that option, like this sound 1 source. So from here I select the sound. Okay. So from here I have to select. This one is the crow sound. Yeah, and this call sound one play to something. This is available in the sound one. Over here you can see. Now what I did is, I did not work so hard to take each and every block from each and every place. Once I selected the whole thing for the screen, like when dog is clicked, this I selected from this pin. What I did is, otherwise I selected a block, I duplicated it, and this came over here, and I just changed the IDs. So clever. Okay, I'll try to do as well. In the fruit screen also, it is the same. When the apple is clicked, set this sound, and then I have used the new type of block that shows set fruit labels text to fruit click this apple. Now where I get these blocks from, I'll show you. First let me show you all. So these all are arranged in a very nice format, not like the earlier one below the other. This is arranged in a row, and again this is also arranged in a row. Even I can say three columns are there in three rows. Okay, now it's the same as I said. Now I'll show you where I get this from. For example, I select the when strawberry is clicked. So from here I search for strawberry. Here is the strawberry. I take this block. Set sound one source to strawberry.mp3. It's strawberry.mp3. See, strawberry.mp3. It's hidden behind this. So I go to sound one. I select set sound one source to. From here I select strawberry.mp3, not PNGs, okay? Be careful, because PNGs are the screenshot formats. I'll tell you what are the difference between JPEG, PNG and then. First let me finish coding, then if I have time, then. Then set fruit labels text to fruit click this strawberry. So here, from here I choose this fruit label. Set fruit labels text to, I place this below. In the middle there is call sound once play. I'll place that later. First let me write this. So I'll just copy it and not work so hard. And here I use the call sound once play. Yeah, it's done. And if the next time I want to do for orange, I duplicate it. I place it over here. From here I choose orange. From here I choose orange.mp3. Never mind. And like this, this I change to orange. If I want to delete it, I'll delete it from here. I'll delete both because the coding is already done. And when the home button is clicked, navigate to home. But it's a bit different for the color scheme. Because when the red button, these are buttons, right? When the red button is clicked, set sound one source to red.mp3. Call sound one play, this play call play button, it's the same. Now as it has some text, it needs to be set as the set red font size to 24, set red height to 120, set red width to 120. Because if you notice carefully, the next time I'll show you, when I click on it, this shrinks and then it again gets bigger. So for that I need to choose the height and width of it. Now wait for 2 seconds, it will stay shrink for 2 seconds, then it will again become as it was earlier, its size. So it will again change its size like this. Okay, the same for all these buttons. What I do is, I just duplicate this block, place it over here, just change the IDs. So it will take much time for me to change all these IDs now. As you don't have much time, you have just come to my channel to learn coding, and I think this coding is clear. So why am I using this block? So that the sound plays. If this block is not, I'm sorry. If this block is not used, then the sound will not play. Now I'll just quickly preview these, and after that I'll try to tell you something. Now this app is kiddish because it's meant for kids. So the story is that one nursery teacher told me to create an app where kids can learn animals' names, fruit names and color names very easily. For that I created this. This is the story behind this. I click on this animals and you have to wait for a while but all the images appear. So I think my sound is shared, yes. I click on the dog, see. I'll review everything. Meow. This is fun, right? Kids can learn the sounds of the animals in this video. And I click on home. I again reach home. Now I click on fruits. Let all of fruit images appear.
Apple.
Here you can see the label is changing. Like fruit click this, apple.
Banana.
Fruit click this, banana.
Mango. Orange. Strawberries. Watermelon.
See, every time I'm clicking, this label is changing. I shift to home and I choose color. See, when I click on red, it shrinks.
Red.
It says red. When I click on blue, it shrinks.
Blue.
And it says blue.
Yellow.
It shrinks and it says yellow.
Black.
See?
Pink. Green.
And home. I think this is really clear to you. This was my class project for my 35th Vaika Junior class, and I have done it. It took some time for me, but once it's done, you see, it's so good. And from where will you upload all the image files, image components? From here in the file section. There are so many uploaded. So here you can see an option like choose file or drag it here. You click on it, and all your image files and all files from this PC appears like this. And if you want to add some data sources, you can, but in this app you really don't need any data sources. See, there are so many things. If you want to delete one file, you can delete from here. If you want to rename one, you can rename by using this. There are three sets of files. Okay. I think this coding is understood. You won't have any problem while creating this kiddish app anymore. And I hope for the best that once you create this app, kindly let me know in the comment section how you like it. You need not share it with me because I have this kiddish app with me. I won't also share it with you, and it's not available in the description box also. You can check. But in the description box, the Thunkable's website link is available. That's Thunkable.com. You can click on it and you can go to Thunkable, create an account and start building all this. If you don't have a pro account, you can create with a basic account which can make up to only 10 projects. But as you can see, in my account, I have created more than 10 projects. I haven't shifted to the pro yet. So how I did that? I made a new account. You know, I have many email IDs. Only one. I use only one, which is important to me. Which ID I won't give you. So I have many YouTube channels for which I have many YouTube IDs. Currently I'm using the one which is mine. Okay. I hope you like this video. Then put a thumbs up to this and subscribe to Coding Station. And don't forget to share it with your friends. And leave a comment below. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you soon. Bye-bye.